As we watch our Earth spinning, let's stop to admire how beautiful it is. With around 71% of the Earth's surface covered by water, the land that rises up in between stands out vibrantly on the stark, deep blue depths of the oceans and seas. The land that we can see are called continents. The Earth contains 7 continents, that being North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Asia, Australia, and lastly, the icy tundra of Antarctica. Now you might be asking yourself, where did all these continents come from? Have we always had this many continents? Let's take a step back in time to figure out the answers to these questions today. Welcome to Earth from around 335 million years ago. Do you notice anything different? That's right. There aren't 7 continents anymore. But instead, there's mostly one massive landmass. This land was known as Pangea, also known as a supercontinent. And it was largely centered around the equator. The equator is the centermost latitudinal line of the Earth and the warmest. Pangea was composed of a number of areas, named in part to what landmasses they would eventually form. These areas were named Eurasia, North America, South America, Africa, India, Antarctica, and Australia. Pangea was also surrounded by 3 primary oceans, that being the Penthalassa Ocean, the Paleotethys Ocean, and the Tethys Ocean. Having formed from previous continental clusters, Pangea is where the stepping stones of life would proliferate and evolve to what we see today. During the time of Pangea, the first dinosaurs appeared around 230 million years ago. And even the earliest mammals around 210 million years ago. Creatures grew and thrived in this land, with a vastly diverse biodiversity forming during this long period. Beginning around 175 million years ago, in the early to mid-Jurassic period, Pangea began to break apart. The resulting supercontinents that could be seen during this early separation was that of Laurasia and Gondwana, which connected the North America and Eurasia areas to the north and the other landmasses to the south, with the Tethys Ocean filling the gaps in between. And the resulting failed rifts slowly formed landmasses that were separated increasingly further apart by bodies of water that eventually developed into the seas and oceans we know today. As the land separated over time, life still went on and evolved. This could give possible reasoning as to why dinosaurs have existed and evolved uniquely across the continents. As the areas of Pangea were continuously splitting, the result was a large release of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. The resulting warmer temperatures further affected the rapidly changing biodiversity and affected the future generations of dinosaurs and all other life on Earth. As the last of the known dinosaurs began to disappear around 65 million years ago, and new life began to take over, Pangea separating finally began to settle around 50 million years ago, when India collided with Eurasia, forming the Himalayas. This mountain range contains the highest peak on Earth, Mount Everest. For us humans, we are a pretty recent addition to this story. At 2.4 million years ago to 1.4 million years ago, Homo habilis, one of the earliest human ancestors currently known, would have walked around in a world quite similar to the one we know today. But that doesn't mean that they wouldn't have experienced the forces that created our modern Earth. Earthquakes, volcanoes, these natural events are the result of the shifting of the tectonic plates of the Earth, similar to those that led to the separation of Pangea. While we might think the ground under our feet is solid, deep under the land and water our Earth is made up of plates that are constantly shifting and colliding. While we usually don't feel this movement, it's always happening around us. And in the far future, who knows what our Earth will look like? As we admire our modern-day Earth and the seven continents, let's take a moment to appreciate the profound changes that have occurred in the Earth's history over millions of years to bring us to this point, where North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Asia, Australia, and Antarctica exist as we see them today. See you all next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, like, subscribe, click on the bell icon to get notifications for our future videos, and we'll see you in the next one.